It is really embarrassing for somebody to tell you that you do the same thing in bed that your son does in bed.
After you.
Thank you. Looks like a fun place.
Yeah, they have good beer here.
Yeah.
What do you usually drink?
I like plain old-fashioned beer.
Plain old-fashioned beer, my type of woman.
Debbie maybe like this because you don't have a daughter.
A daughter that's gonna replace you.
No, Robert, don't see like that.
You know, we just kind of want to start our own lives now that...
I don't blame you. I just don't like the way he came about telling me. Just the blindsidedness of the whole thing.
We're not trying to abandon you.
Sure, you move in, you steal my son, you know, you kick me out. I understand how it works.
What I told you. Debbie throwing a little shade right there. Debbie throwing light jabs.
Oh, I think she's joking.
I don't think she's joking. I think she's laughing yeah. to make it sound like it's a joke, but I think that she 100% feels that way.
No, I'm not trying to break you guys up. I'm really not.
Colt and I have always had a really close relationship. Colt is my miracle baby.
Oh, look how pretty Mama Debbie is.
When I was younger, the doctor told me I had a problem carrying children that you won't be able to. Years later, I was actually kind of shocked when I got pregnant. But Colt was born really early. He was not expected to live.
He's a survivor.
Colt the survivor. He survived Larissa. He survived Jess in those shoes. Trust me, Colt is a survivor.
Colt is a hero.
I was born head first.
Everyone's born head first. That's the right way.
Feet first.
Oh, my God.
Whatever the opposite of the correct way.
Yeah, thanks.
Feet first, yes.
Breach. Were you premature and on a ventilator and your mom didn't know she could get pregnant? No.
No, but she was disappointed I wasn't a girl.
I would have been too.
And thank God he came through. So Colt and I have a kind of a special bond between us. And it's hard for me to let him go.
You have to let him go and live his married life at some point. Mm-hmm. Deb, come on.
It all makes so much more sense now why they're so like codependent.
Yeah, Debbie, but you know, you have to let your kid fly. You have to let your kid doing their life how you did yours with your husband.
Oh, please. That's I know you ain't talking about that when you was holding the baby. When she barely couldn't even crawl right because you kept holding her nonstop.
Be quiet, because she's 30 years old.
You hold that girl nonstop, and you hold that girl pretty much throughout the whole day.
I don't think he ever wants to hurt my feelings or embarrass me, although he does sometimes. He doesn't mean to. He doesn't have a lot of finesse.
He does not.
Everybody blames Colt, but Debbie needs to let go. He's not a baby no more. He's not a preemie no more.
They don't cut umbilical cord when Colt is born. So they need to call the doctor for doctor cut the umbilical cord.
Yeah, it's good that we get away from each other for a while.
And then bringing the guy over for you won't be so awkward.
Yeah, that was a little awkward.
Colt was so uncomfortable. Like, Colt was just like, I gotta get the out of here.
I was uncomfortable. It's been a long time since I had some strange man in my bed.
Yeah? Did you like it?
I was very disappointed.
I want to know what was so disappointing about it.
Oh, that's like girls talk, you know? Because you don't want us talking like that in front of Colt.
Hell no. Colt ain't want to hear that.
Uh-oh, why?
He told me to stop talking at one point.
Good, tell her what you said, Debbie. Tell her what you said.
Vanessa's like, I know what you mean.
That's really odd, because I kind of... had that same issue with Colt.
Oh, my God. I'm done.
Damn. She's like, your son also won't shut up when we're doing it. That's what she said. Your brain is, like, short-circuiting.
It is really embarrassing for somebody to tell you that you do the same thing in bed that your son does in bed.
Don't compare
your sex life. Oh, my God.
I would literally never talk to your mama or your stepmama about sex, but there was that time.
I've talked to your mom about sex.
Yeah, but that's because you're weird. And there is that one time that your stepmom asked you.
Yeah.
About right. And right. Your broken penis.
Yeah.
What was life like before Colt?
Oh, it was fantastic. It was easier to meet people because I worked like in cocktail lounges and restaurants and stuff.
So Debbie was a wild child before Colt.
I was. I had a lot of oats to sort, and I sort them all right.
What is that?
That's like when men want to sleep around.
Oh,
she said
Debbie was caliente.
Yeah, she was caliente, muy caliente.
I think I have someone in mind for you.
Yeah?
Yeah. He's a friend of a friend, but I honestly don't know much about him.
Nessa's gonna set her up, huh?
I have my father for her, too. She just had to bring him with a K-1 beat.
A date! So I got chills.
Aww.
I'm very nervous about meeting.
Did she get chills in her nether regions? Do you think that's what she meant?
Oh, God.
I am excited to see Debbie out on the prowl.
I want to see Debbie nervous.
Alerting, showing her little butterfly.
Get that nervous off, Debbie. Get you a couple shots. You know how to do it, girl.
Give me the night, give me the splendor.
Gambling? Who is this, Debbie or Ed? You wanna feel this way. I say Debbie.
Debbie.
Told you, roll my dice right.
Okay, yeah, I'm okay.
I've never been on a blind date before, but right now, most of the people that are DMing me in my app, they want a quickie, a one-night stand, something.
Yeah.
Girl, it's so true, though. Yeah. At all of the ages, all they want is a quickie.
That's surprising to me that people are wanting quickies and from Debbie. Like,
I don't know. Nobody said all that.
Now eyeliner is really back, and that's what I used to wear in the 60s and 70s and even early 80s.
Oh, look how young she Debbie was.
Wow, baby. Debbie. You're so beautiful.
Debbie's a little hot mama, yo.
I was a
damn, Debbie.
Debbie was having some fun back in the day.
That is some hair.
That's a honeydew. My mom
a
had
beehive,
that.
Beehive, not a honeydew.
Beehive, yeah.
A honeydew.
No, there was one called a honeydew, too, but the beehive is the one my mom used to rock.
I had a one-night stand with the Marlboro man. We f***ed our brains out. What do you want to say?
The Marlboro man? She banged the Marlboro man? No way.
Hold up. You f***ed a cigarette man?
Even though my mother's upset with the news of us moving out and the fact that she will be living on her own, I'm still rooting for her on this date.
What the hell has Colt got in his hand? Mini cones? Or is he just huge?
Colt's eating the tiniest ice cream.
Are you nervous?
Yeah, I'm nervous.
So what's his name?
Edward.
Edward?
I call him Eddie. Hey, Eddie.
That's cute. Flirt a little bit.
Cole, how you feel about mommy going out?
I'm telling you, I just cannot imagine living with my mom.
And her be dating and doing it?
Yeah, like, I can't fathom it.
I'm gonna go get it.
Oh my God.
You stay here.
I'm so excited.
Here goes, Debbie. Take a deep breath.
Let's see what he looks like.
The last date I went on was a disaster, and if this turns out to be another disaster, then it might set me back to thinking maybe I'm not ready to date, or maybe I'm not, maybe just not dateable. How's that?
No, Debbie, don't say that. You're so dateable. You will find the perfect man.
Oh, my God. I want to see the guy.
Mama, remember when we set you up on that blind date?
Yeah, I do. And that's when I never trusted you again. That wasn't funny. That was not funny.
You had a good time. I did. Want to hear it.
He's dead.
Oh, my God.
He died of cancer.
Damn it, Mama, we could have been sad. And you would have just hung on a little bit longer.
No, I don't use nobody.